We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Discover Newport, Chef Christopher Maitland. It's here from 15 Point Road Restaurant. We're making native sole and brick. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Great to have you here today. All right, we know what sole is.
Yes.
What's the in brick?
The in brick is actually this pastry that I get. It's a French pastry. You have to keep it frozen or refrigerated. Fruit de brick means leaves of pastry.
Oh, okay. All right, so that's what it means. All right, so we have a bunch of ingredients here. Some of the stuff you actually had to prepare a little of it ahead of time because the rice needed a little time. It takes a little while to actually...
Yeah, 20 minutes.
About 20 minutes to cook. So let's go over the ingredients slow here so everybody at home who is writing down this recipe can, you know, knows what we're making today.
Okay, I have native sole that I get from various places in Newport and in Portsmouth. I have the stock that I've cooked from the vegetable medley that's going to be the sauce. There's leeks, carrots. I have a spice mixture with cardamom, sesame, a little bit of cinnamon. There's leeks, tomatoes, butternut squash, and then salt and pepper.
Okay. For anybody who, you know, I mean, a lot of people will eat, you know, seafood, a lot of people have fish. What sort of taste does the sole have? I mean, is it more of a flaky fish, or how is it?
Very light.
Lighter fish.
It's very light, yes.
And the fish will be wrapped in the pastry?
Yes, it will.
And then cooked in the oven. Okay.
And steamed, yeah.
All right, when we're going to the, you know, our local fishery looking for fish, what are we looking for when we're looking for the sole?
Well, you want to see something that is, you know, that's fresh, obviously. If it has a little bit of clarity to it where you can kind of see through it a little bit, it's even better. This dish works well with halibut as well. Or you can even use cod, but cod, you know, isn't quite as durable as the sole is.
Okay, so this is just, you know, I mean, you're using sole. We can actually put any type of fish in it that,
you can.
That we need. What are some of the things we need? We need the pans ready to go because we're also going to toss this in the oven later.
Yes.
And what else will we be serving with it? What is this dish right here?
This is going to become the sauce. It's going to become the sabayon that goes with it. I'm going to cook this back, heat this back up into the vegetable stock, add some cream, and hit it with an immersible blender. That's going to make the sauce for underneath.
Okay, one of the biggest things on the menu at the restaurant?
It's pretty popular.
Pretty popular. Okay, perfect. All right, we have all of our ingredients ready to go. We're going to get cooking in just a little bit. In the meantime, back to you.
But for now, we're going to be heading back to that kitchen. How's it going, Will?
It's going very well. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen again. Discover Newport. Chef Christopher Maitland is here from 15 Point Road Restaurant, making native sole and brick. But right now, we're actually going to make the garnish that goes with the sole, correct?
Yes, we are.
All right. And once again, just tell everybody what we need for this, you know, to get this going.
Well, I have leeks here. They need to be split and washed. They have sand in them all the time, so you have to split them this way lengthwise. We have carrots. And tomatoes. It's basically a very simple garnish, but it's the way it's prepared that makes it most delectable. You want to render them down so they're still tender, crisp. So I'm going to need to start with some olive oil.
Okay, and just a little heat on this.
Yep. Right, if so you would grab the oil for me there.
Okay. There we go. And passing this to you. All right, so I'm going to put this in here first. About what temperature do we need this, you know, the heat for the pan?
Well, I want to bring it up hot at first, and then we're going to turn it down so it'll sweat.
Okay.
We don't want it to brown.
All right.
So, okay. And if you would you mind peeling this?
Okay,
there's a plate over there if you want to grab that.
Grab this here. We'll peel a little of these. Put this on here.
I'm going to cut these leeks. I usually cut them this way. You can actually cut them in segments like this and julienne them like that, which also makes a really nice appearance. But for this sake, I'll cut them like this.
Okay. And this is, I mean, what kind of flavor is this? Is it more of a sweet taste to it? I mean, depending on, you know, how it's all mixed together?
Everything is pretty sweet on this dish. The leeks, the carrots, and eventually the butternut squash. But, that's how you'll peel that.
Okay.
And I do have some that's already shredded. But, and it's easy to use that way. But if you want, you can...
Just chop it up and then chop it into smaller...
Cut it small, yeah.
Right.
So it'll sweat quicker.
And we'll put this in. How about how long is it going to take?
This is probably going to take like 2 minutes.
Okay, 2 minutes for that. All right, perfect. All right, so we've got our ingredients in the pan. We're going to get cooking just a little more, get all that sole mixed together. Back to you. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Discover Newport. Chef Christopher Maitland is here from 15 Point Road Restaurant, making native sole and brick. Once again, can we just tell everybody what in brick is? I mean, everybody, they'll know what sole is. What's the in brick?
The in brick is actually this pastry, yeah. It's called Frieda Brick. It means leaves of pastry. You can get it, I get it from Newport Specialty Foods in Newport, in Middletown actually. And it's hard to handle because it's very, very thin and it makes things crispy.
Oh, almost like a flaky crust?
Yeah, it is flaky.
Resemble that. All right. We've been doing some of our cooking. You chopped up some of the vegetables a little earlier. And now what are we going to do?
We're going to make the sauce and the fish.
All right. Let's get cracking.
Alrighty. What I'm going to do here is I pre-made this so that it wouldn't take so long. It's squash rendered down with rice, onions, and carrots.
So put that right in there. And the reason why you had to, you know, prepare this just ahead of time is because the rice would have taken a long time to actually
cook. It would have, yes. It would have taken 20 minutes. So I'm going to crank this up. This is just the vegetable stock that was in there before.
Okay.
It also has the seasoning in it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's going to be mixed up with
an immersible blender. And what is that seasoning that we put in?
It's a cinnamon mix that I make with cardamom and other things.
Okay. So. All right. So we got that on probably about a high heat here?
Yeah, I want to bring that up quickly.
Bring that up quick so it
This one as support. Well. Okay. If I could have a little bit of olive oil.
A little more olive oil. Put that on there.
Okay.
There you go.
It's making a little noise there.
Put that in.
Alrighty.
And this is also on a higher heat.
Yeah, and we're going to get one of these pastries out. It comes layered in these protective sheets. Then you just peel it away.
So it is. It's very thin. I mean, it's like
you can
a tissue. You can see right through it.
Yeah,
you can see right through it.
So
put that down.
This one there.
You gotta be careful with that.
Yeah, and if it dries at all, or even if it's frozen, which it is best kept frozen, you have to keep it flat because I mean it'll break.
It'll crack easy.
It'll crack up. You'll lose the edges and so forth.
All right. While we're doing this, tell everybody about the restaurant that about the restaurant where you work.
15 Point Road in Portsmouth. It's owned by Sean and Carly Smith. It's a beautiful spot, really cozy. If you go down off Park Avenue, you'll see the place right on the waterfront. Really, really nice, very quaint.
And these are one of the specialties you make at the restaurant?
Yes.
All right. Okay, so we've got the brick. This is boiling away.
I'm going to start the sole here. I'm going to wrap it up.
So you place that in the middle. And these are like thinner pieces of the
fish.
It is,
and I had previously dried it up so that it won't seep through.
Okay.
It needs to be relatively dry, so.
And how did you do that, just for everybody at home?
You can pat it dry with a paper towel or a side towel.
All right. So
then
wrap that up.
Wrap this way with a heavy amount of crust on one side so that it'll stay crispy. And this will be the side that goes down onto the pan,
mm-hmm.
and then I'll flip it up and finish it in the oven.
Now, we've preheated this oven. What temperature do you have the oven on?
It's at 350.
350, okay.
This fish will steam as well as toast because it's in this encasement, so it'll cook quite fast.
All right. And because this is so thin, how long is this going to actually stay on this pan here?
As soon as it browns, it's going to take probably a minute and a half. Oh, could I have that butternut squash there?
Squash? There you go.
Just to show you. You can use, with the butternut squash, this side is full of seeds, and this side is just, you know.
Basically just the.
It's all the meat. So what you'll need is, put this out of the way. You can use just this part and save the other for something else. But
okay.
It's hard to trim. You can't really use a peeler. You need a knife.
Because it has a thick skin on it.
It is very, very tough. So you want to carve it away like this,
mm-hmm.
and then you can dice it up any way you want to use for whatever. You could actually shred it, but you need to take away the skin
and
first.
And this, because we're running short on time, this is going to brown just a little bit. We're going to put this in the oven, and how long will it cook in the oven?
This will probably take about 4 to 5 minutes.
About 4 to 5 minutes? Okay.
But you want to make sure that you have the right doneness.
Okay. All right, we're going to put this in the oven and let it cook for just a little bit. We'll show you the finished product in just a little while. Back to you.